Good morning. It's good to be in the house of the Lord, amen? Everybody stand this morning. Join with us. Clap your hands. One drink into the night, wanting a place to hide this weary soul.
Good morning, church. gosh, dog, you are an amazing group of people to see. Wow. We had a great time. You know, the best part of going someplace is coming home. Amen. I came in here Wednesday night. I told them when I turned north on 166, I started smiling, and I haven't quit yet. So it's glad to see you. We're glad to see you. I hope you came today ready. Because I've been writing this sermon for 2.5 weeks. Yep. Brother Keith did an amazing job while we were gone. Amen. Just did an amazing job. Crystal said, you know, they've been getting out pretty early while you're gone. I said, yeah, I know. I'll break them of that probably. Maybe not. I don't know. But it'll all be good. That's all I can promise you. It'll all be good because God will be in it. We're glad you're here this morning. We pray that you've come to worship. We want to just uplift the name of Jesus. That's all we want to do this morning is just praise the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. All right? You all know what's going on better than I do, so I'm not even going to make the announcements. Just prayer meeting tonight at 5 in the chapel, church tonight at 6. Pray for these people up here. Pray for the people beside you. Pray for the people joining us online. You live in the only place, I think, in the whole of America, perhaps the world, that you can have frost in the morning and 70 degrees in the afternoon. Amen. You can't get that everywhere. So how blessed are you? You got to like frost, and I don't. All right, let's pray. Father, we thank you for your love. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you, Father, for the opportunity and the privilege of being in this place with these people, with your promise that you will join us in our midst. Lord, we've come together in your name. We've come together to worship you, to uplift it, to praise you. And Lord, we just want that to happen through the songs that are sung. May the message and the music this morning speak to hearts, touch hearts, change lives through the power of the Holy Spirit. Lord, we pray for your leadership and guidance and your anointing upon this stage, upon those who listen to us online and watch us, upon all those in this congregation, that we might shut the world out, that we might set everything aside, and we would just concentrate upon what you have for us today. May we look for it. May we search for it. May we be open to it and willing to receive what you have for us. Lead us and guide us, Father. May all we say and all we do bring you praise and honor. Amen.
God is good, amen. Let's worship this morning. I can't stand still, so get up and don't let me look for crazy.
It's like sweet, sweet honey on my lips. It's like the sound of a symphony to my ears. It's like holy water on my skin. Woo! Dead men walking slaves.
Where I belong. You unravel me with a melody. You surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemy, until all my fears are gone and I'm no longer a slave to fear. No, I am the child of God. I'm no longer a slave to fear. From my mother's womb, you have chosen me. Love has called my name. I've been born again into your family. Your blood flows through my veins. And I'm no let us sing our freedom.
something to say, and this is hard. You guys are kind of scary. Anybody feel like they're in a struggle? I do. If I wasn't so nervous, I'd hold up two arms and one leg, because that's how it is sometimes. A struggle with your job, maybe your family, maybe your kids. I don't know. But I know God is here today, and He wants you to give Him that struggle, whatever it is. You may think, I can't say that to someone. I can't tell them something. But guess what? We all have a lot of somethings that are hard. And you are not alone. And I have friends who are going to come up here, and they're going to pray with you. And so you are not alone. God is already here. We prayed this morning before service started that God would be waiting on people at the altar. So all you have to do is be brave and stand up and give whatever it is, whatever your struggle is, to God. And He will take it and do exceedingly and abundantly more than we can ever even think to ask Him. But all you have to do is stand up. So I know there are people who are struggling, because I am, and I can't be alone. I'm certain I'm not alone. So if you're struggling, give it to God. He will give you a peace that you don't even understand. It doesn't even make sense. I've seen it. So give it to Him today.
Your mercy never fails me.
and he is reaching out and he is calling for you, and not just to give burdens and things, but to give praise and honor, because he is good and he is faithful.
They say sometimes you win some, sometimes you lose some. Right now I'm losing bad.
How many's there?
I've stood on this stage night after night, reminding the broken it'll be alright. Right now, oh, right now I just can't. It's easy to see there's nothing to bring me down. What will I say when I'm held to the flame like I am right now? I know you're able and I know you can save through the fire with your mighty hand, but they say it only takes a little faith to move a mountain. Good thing is a little faith is all I have right now. Not when you choose to leave mountains unmoved. Be able to sing, it is well with my soul. I know you're able and I know you can save through the fire with your mighty hand, but even if you don't, my hope is you alone. I know the sorrow.
Krista said something very profound. We're all struggling. We all have struggles. We come in here and we look at everybody, you know, and they look like they've got it all together. When in reality, half the time we can't even find it, let alone have it together. All right? That's why we're here, by the way. It's what this place is about. It's a place of worship, but it's also a hospital. Healing for the hurting. Healing for the broken. God is the only one that can put your life back together. You need to just quit trying on your own, because you're doing the same thing I'm doing. You're just making a mess of it. If you want it to get it back together, let God do it for you and quit trying to do it yourself. Every place you look in this world, there is trouble, there is torment, there is selfishness, there is unhappiness. That's not God's design. And you don't have to live that way unless you want to keep living that way. They're going to sing one song, probably two in a row here, that are powerful. That the message in these songs, you're looking for something today, right now. You're not even sure what it is. I'm getting ready to tell you, you're looking for the Lamb of God. Because he will stand when everything else is falling apart. He will be the one you need to see when you can't see anything else. Amen. You need to see the Lamb of God, the conquering King, the Lion of the tribe of Judah. Folks, that is what we need to see. But we're seeing everything but that. All the bad, all the wrong, all the hurt, and all the stuff in the world, folks. That's not what God's about. God is about what he wants to do right now. Fix your struggle. I want you to listen to the message in this song. Not just the music, but I want you to listen to the message. And if the Lord leads, Greg's going to go right in to another one about the ability to see God face to face. You're going to tell you.
Standing in heaven with tears in his eyes, saying, tell me this isn't so. For there was no one in heaven and no one on earth worthy to open the scroll. Then one said, John, don't you cry, it's all part of the plan. And then in the center of God's glorious throne, hallelujah, there stood a lamb. And they sang, said, I'll come quickly, so don't be surprised.
he comes back to take us away. Now people, excuses won't get very far when you find yourself there at his throne. But if you know Jesus and he is your Lord, hallelujah, you won't be alone. And we'll sing, worthy, worthy of honor and praise. We'll be casting down crowns, and we'll be
churches today. We think our last name has to be Graham, as in Billy Graham and his bunch, before you can ever hear anything from God. You know, we think you got to be somebody or have pastor or deacon or teacher or something like that after your name before you're going to hear from God. You know who God wants to talk to? Every one of us. And he is talking to every one of us. If you want to hear from God, they're getting ready to tell you how to get just face to face with God. And if you think that's just something they did in the Bible, oh, God love your heart, you just don't know. He will talk to you face to face as real as I'm talking to you now. You say, well, how will I know it's him? You will know. You will know. And once you have been in that presence, and once you have heard that voice, and once you get in there, all you want to do is go back. Because you've been in the presence of Almighty God, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. By the way, in case you have forgotten, if you know Jesus as your personal Savior, you are one of his children. Your Father created all this. And we don't even act like we can hear his voice. My parents and my dad has been gone for years, but I can hear his voice in my head right now. Right now I can hear it. Can you hear your Heavenly Father's voice? It's not that he's not talking. Right now is the time. God set this whole thing up knowing you were going to be here. Whether you planned it or whether you didn't, here you are. Now you're in the middle of it. You got to deal with it. But God knew what was happening. God knew what was coming. God knew I wasn't going to get to preach my 2.5-hour message. Amen. Amen, brother. But I'm telling you this morning, if I know anything at all, I know this. God is here, and he's here right now. And he is here for you. All God is waiting on to change your life is you. All God is waiting on to fix your mess is you. All God needs from you is just enough faith to step out. Or if you can't step out, just raise your hand and say, hey, come pray for me, and somebody will be there, I guarantee it. Greg's going to tell you now. You're in the presence of God right now, but Greg's going to tell you how to get face to face with God. And that is up to you. That is your privilege. I never one time told my children, my father never one time told me, I can't talk to you right now, I'm too busy. I always made time. My dad always made time, and your heavenly father will always make time. You know why? Because he loves you. He loves you more than you even realize. And just like every good father, he wants the best for you. Let's sing, Greg.
Oh, I'm a traveler, far from home. I get lost, but I press on. 'Cause there's a mansion and streets of gold where we belong. Yes, there's a day coming soon where the old will be made and heaven's glory shines like the morning before our eyes. When we all see Jesus, when we all see Jesus, no more sickness and no more madness and no more pain. There will be a great rejoicing. Holy, holy, worthy, worthy is the Lamb. Oh, when we all see Jesus.
in my name. My God's so much bigger than troubles I face. And why would I hunger for power or riches or fame? Oh, my God is so much better than all of these things. So I won't be shamed. Thank you.
And you just thought you were done with me. Anybody, can you put that slide up there? There's no problem too big. There's no weapon too strong. There's nothing that's impossible with my God. What's the next slide? There's no mountain too high. Listen to this. You've heard this all morning long. If you're here and you've got burdens this morning, if you've got something going on in your life, there's no mountain too big, no valley too low. There's no fear that I have. He doesn't already know. He already knows what's going on. All he's waiting is for you to come and talk to him about it. That's all he needs this morning. That's all he wants, is for you to open up to God this morning. He's waiting for you. I don't know who this service is for. It's been for a lot of people. But there's somebody still here. There's somebody that's still here this morning that God is carrying this on for you. So don't wait. What's the next slide? Because I believe the next one's a good one too. You're right. It is all good. There's no mountain too high. There's no valley too low. That's the one we just did. You got the next slide? There's no problem too big. Thank you, Matt. He thinks he knows a song. There's no problem too big. There's no weapon too strong. There's nothing for God that's impossible. There's nothing impossible for God for you this morning. You think your problems are big? It's small to God. They're small. We think our problems here on this earth are bad and terrible and big, but it is nothing that God can't handle. All you got to do is be willing to turn it over to him this morning. Listen to the Holy Spirit. Welcome him into your heart this morning. Welcome him and say, yes, I'm here. I'm going to come. I'm going to listen. I'm going to hear and obey your word today as we sing another song.
I've been held by the Savior. I fell far from above. I've been down to that river. But I ain't the same. A prodigal. breaks him down to his knees. And God, I've been broken more than a time or two. But then he picked me up and showed me what it means.
Nothing better than you.
to talk to you. Get up there.
I'm going to talk back to you, though.
Well, don't talk bad. Did you see the words on that screen that just went off? He can turn graves into gardens. He can turn a pile of dead, dry bones into an army. He can make a highway through the sea that when they crossed, they didn't even get mud on their feet. But you think he can't fix what's wrong in your life. I'm not lying, and you know it. And let me tell you what else you think. You think he'll do it for everybody but you. Well, you're wrong. He'll do it for everybody and you. All he needs you to do is let him do it. Just let him do it. Now, I know, some of y'all are a little freaked out right now. This is not what you signed up for when you walked in this morning. If you want to blame me, go ahead, but I didn't set this whole thing in motion. I had a really good message I was going to preach. So if you want to get sideways with somebody, you get sideways with God, but you ain't going to win that one. I'm just telling you. Try it. You're not going to win. I said it earlier. I'm going to say it again. God knew who was going to be here. And God knows exactly what we need better than we know what we need. Now, if you ain't got it yet, what are you waiting on? If you have got it and you want some more of it, well, get it. There's no limit.
Last night, I was sitting up in my backyard in the swing. Just me and the Lord. And I wanted to do what he wanted me to do. Brother Eddie, where'd you go to? You're going to sit down for a while, okay? But a couple of things come across my mind. How can we have a service tomorrow without you, Lord? We can't. Y'all see what the evidence of the Holy Spirit moving this morning here in this congregation? Give God the praise. But I have stood in Brother Eddie's shoes, being a pastor. And I know how sometimes it is. I went to church on Sunday morning, heartbroken. Didn't know how I was ever going to get through the service. Well, we made it through, and God gave me some of the best messages I ever preached because he was in it. So I was thinking about what can we do for Brother Eddie. One thing I want to remind you of, we need to pray for him. Every day, several times a day. Because he's the soldier out here in front of an army that is facing the devil head on. And you don't think the devil doesn't work on the pastor of a church? He sees things going on in his church that just breaks his heart. What can I do, Lord? How can I solve this problem? It don't come easy sometimes, you know. So I thought, well, you know what? Tomorrow I'd like to do this. When the band quits playing after the first song, then I was going to get up, come up here, and shake my pastor's hand and hug his neck and let him know that I love him and I'm behind him 100%. And I thought, then I'll just have everybody else follow me. Wouldn't that be a grand parade? Huh? Brother Eddie could stand here. Is Crystal here this morning? Is Crystal here this morning? Over here somewhere? Okay, well, I didn't want to leave her out because she's important too. As my wife is important. If you don't know that, ask her. Because you can't be a pastor and not have a godly woman as a wife. I thought, well, you know what? It might take too much time. So what else can we do to show Eddie that we appreciate him and we love him and we're praying for him constantly every day, every night. We pray for our pastor because he stands in front of us people, between the devil and us. So here's what I come up with. I'm just going to get up there and stand up and say, I love my pastor. I love him with all my heart, and I'll help him to the very end of time if it takes necessary. And I wanted him to come up here. I love you, brother.
Thank you, my friend. Thank you, brother. Now, come here.
Well, that must have been a God's plan, because I turned around. You guys are already standing. That's what I'm going to ask you to do. If you love your pastor, stand and let him know about it. Did you get the message?
Got it.
Got it. All right. Good.
Cast my mind to Calvary, where Jesus bled and died for me. Sing along with me. I see his wounds, his hands, his feet, my Savior on that cursed tree. His body bowed and drenched in tears, they laid him down in Joseph's tomb, the entrance sealed by heavy stone. Messiah still and all alone.
Come on, let's praise him.
Oh, praise the name of the Lord our God. Oh, praise his name forevermore, for endless days
band's got about six more songs they can do. But I don't know how much more y'all can stand.
All day.
All day. Oh, I hope Domino's will deliver out here then. They will. Somebody said they will. Tell you what we're gonna do. We never dismiss. You guys know that. I never dismiss it. Never dismissed from the presence of God. That's how the Lord impressed that upon me years ago, we're just not. We don't have a closing prayer. We don't have a dismissal. We never dismiss. We just go from service to service, trying to stay in the presence of God. I'm going to let y'all go, or you can stay. I don't know what these guys are going to do. They're wore out. I'm wore out. I ain't done nothing. Try to keep up. I think they're going to sing again. If you want to go at the end of this song, you're not going to upset anybody. If you want to stay, we'll sing them to death. Near death.
I raise a hallelujah in the presence of my enemies. I raise a hallelujah louder than the unbelief. I raise a hallelujah. Thank you.
this song reinforces everything that is going on here this morning. Because if you leave this place without believing what has happened and what is happening and what we're believing is going to continue to happen, it's all been for naught. You have to take from here what you got and use it the rest of the week. Or it was just a good time. God is a God of every day, not just on Sunday. What you felt today, you can feel every day. God don't live here. He lives at your house and at my house and every other house. It's just a place we come together to get with Him. You need to believe what you've seen, what you've heard, and what you've felt. And that's what this song's about.
God's really working today, because there's never in a million years would I be up in front of everybody in this church where anybody can see me, let alone speaking. But I just really feel God leading me to remind everybody that if we're a child of God, not only will He fix our problems and not only will He break our burdens down, but His Spirit is within us. His strength is within us. And if we are willing, He will use us and will do more with us than we could ever imagine. The apostles were normal people just like you and me.
That's right.
And He used them, and that Spirit is not gone. That Spirit has not left the earth. God is still here with us.
That's right.
There was sickness then. There's sickness now. There were heartbroken people then. There are heartbroken people now. And the things those apostles did, that Spirit is within us. That strength is within us. And we just have to be willing to let God use us to do the things, to show the world that He's here. There's more to it than what I've been led to believe. There's more to it than my years of being a child and learning, but more than I was ever taught. And so I just really felt God impressing on me today to just maybe remind us that He's here, but there's more. It's more than just feeling good, and it's more than just helping one another. It's letting Him use us to do amazing things.
Amen. Amen. Okay, Chris. Again, if you agree with this song, sing it like you do. If you don't, listen to the words, and by the end, you should be agreeing.
Hey.
Okay? All right, that's how it is.
In this time of desperation, when all we know is doubt and fear, there is only one foundation we believe in this broken generation, when all is dark, You help us see. There is only one salvation. Oh, we believe in God the Father. We believe in Jesus Christ. We believe in the Holy Spirit. He's given us new life. We believe in the crucifixion. We believe that He conquered death. We believe in the resurrection. And He's coming back again. We believe. So let our faith be more than anthems, be greater than the songs we sing. And in our weakness and temptation, oh, we believe. Oh,
shake hands with somebody, tell them you love them, hug their neck. If they say, I can't leave, bring them to this altar. God ain't going anywhere. God bless you. Have a great day. Come back tonight, 6 o'clock. We're just going to go home, take a nap, and start all over again. Amen.